Hey there, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to create a zoom effect in DaVinci Resolve. Whether you're a beginner or an experienced video editor, this effect can add a lot of impact to your footage. So if you're ready to take your videos to the next level, stay tuned and let's get started. So I'm in DaVinci Resolve now, and there are actually a couple of ways to do this, and I'll start by showing you a simple ease in and ease out zoom effect that we will apply directly to our clip. This is pretty simple to do, and there are a couple of steps in this process. So first we have to find the point where we want our zoom effect to begin and add a keyframe there. So I have this random clip here, and I wanted to create my zoom effect here where I throw this rock. So let's say I would like my zoom in effect to begin somewhere here. So what you want to do is go to transform here up in the right top corner and press this keyframe button. And after you have created your first keyframe, you want to move 10 frames into your timeline. You can do this by using the right arrow key. And of course, if you'd like, you can move less frames or more frames. If you move less, it means that your zoom in effect will be faster. If you move more frames, it means that your zoom in effect will be longer. In my case, I'm gonna move 10 frames. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And now we can actually zoom in our clip. And you can do that in the transform settings. You want to select this Y axis and move it up to around 1.3. You can of course use more. This just means that your zoom effect will be further in. So you can do like this, but I'm gonna keep it at 1.3 in my example here. And now our zoom in effect is almost ready. There's just one last thing that we have to do, and that is add this ease in effect. So what you want to do is go back to the first keyframe that we created, right click the keyframe, press this ease out option, and then go back to the second keyframe, right click again and press ease in. This will create a smoother transition for your zoom in effect. And we can actually see what's going on under the hood if we go to our clip and select this little icon here. Let's zoom in a little bit. And you can see here that this is our zoom in effect here. And you can see that instead of a linear, like a straight line, it's a curved line. And this just smooths out the zoom in effect. And it looks like this. And the last thing that we're gonna do is create zoom out effect, so we're not just zoomed in all the time. So let's remove this now, let's zoom back out a little bit, and it's actually the same way that we did it before. So here zoom in begins, we want to find where we want our zoom out to begin, so let's say somewhere here. You want to create a keyframe there, move 10 frames again, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You want to zoom out or reverse the changes that you made. Let's put it back to 1. There we go. You want to go back to the previous keyframe, press ease out, and go back to the last keyframe and press ease in, and that's it. Let's see how it looks together. I think it looks pretty good. All right, so that's it for method number one. I think that these are pretty good building blocks for you guys, especially those who are just beginning with DaVinci Resolve. This creates a super simple zoom in effect that you can use on your videos. And let's move on to the method number two, which will be a little bit more complex, but still super easy to do. So in the second method, I want to show you a way that you can zoom in on a specific area in your video using Fusion. Fusion does get a bit scary, but this is easy to do if you just follow the steps that I'm going to show you. The first thing for us to do is to go to Effects and search for Adjustment Clip. So let's go toolbox, search, adjustment clip, and you want to drag this where you want your zoom in to begin, on top of your clip. So let's find our spot where we want the zoom to begin. Kind of wanted to zoom in on this where I destroyed this tree here in the top right corner. So let's say our zoom will begin somewhere around here. Something like this. You want to have it a little bit before you want your zoom to begin, actually. Okay, and now you want to select your adjustment clip, right click, and open in Fusion page. So this will open up the Fusion tab. Now you want to select this media in one, press shift space. So this will bring up this box here, and here you want to search for transform. You want to use this transform XF and press add. So it's going to show up here in the middle. Okay, and now you kind of want to find the exact spot where you want your zoom in to begin. So I'm going to zoom, I think, somewhere around here where I start shooting this beam. So let's say somewhere here. So what you want to do is create a keyframe both for the center tab here and also for the size tab. And you want to do the same thing. You want to move 10 frames or less or more. It depends what you want. I'm going to move 10 frames. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. And now we actually want to create our zoom effect. So you want to change size. I'm going to change this to 2. Change it to 2. And you want to change the position. So I'm going to put it here and on top here, like this. And when you have done that, the zoom is pretty much ready, but we have to create the smoother transition effect. And in Fusion, you have to do it a little bit differently. You want to go up here in the top right corner. There's a spline section. Press this. You have to check the transform one. You can press this zoom in, zoom to fit. So this is our transition, our zoom effect. And as you can see that it's a straight line. And we want to create a smoother transition. We want to make it a curved line. So what you want to do is select all of these and press S. As you can see, it immediately creates this curved line, which means it's going to be a smoother transition. And now we can actually go back to our editing tab and check this zoom out, see how it looks. So let's see. I think it looks super good. If you want, you can make the zoom longer by just dragging the adjustment clip. And of course, you can create multiple zoom in effects in the same adjustment clip. You could possibly first zoom in the middle, then zoom to the left corner or the right corner. You can do a lot of things with this, and of course also create a zoom out effect, just like we did in the previous method using keyframes. But there's one really cool thing that I want to show you guys. So if we go back to adjustment clip, right click, open in Fusion page, under tools, settings, there is this setting called motion blur. It's gonna be disabled when you just open it up, but you can enable it. You can crank it up to 10. I'm not gonna do that because my system is gonna lag, but I'm gonna try at 5 and see if it works. But this is gonna create like a blur for your zoom effect. Yeah, the 10 is much better, so you should try it out, but it just makes the zoom look better. Alright guys, I hope that this was useful for you and you learned how to create a zoom effect. If it was useful, please leave a like and subscribe, it helps a lot. And let me know in the comments what you want to learn next, so I know what to make videos about. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace.